I'm the Game Professor, and welcome to Games as Lit 101. The Civilization series has an interesting approach to its historical elements. In this long-running series of strategy games, you choose a civilization from across history, from Russia to the Aztecs to the United States, and all sorts of other options, and attempt to become the most advanced civilization across centuries of scientific and cultural development. It's a really neat idea, and each iteration of the long-running series has done an excellent job implementing it. That said, the series also has a complex relationship with history, and it can seem like a really educational game, until it doesn't. So let's see if we can figure this out. Generally speaking, educational games tend to be very direct in their approach. The golden age of educational games, around the late 80s and into the 90s, saw the release of a lot of games like The Oregon Trail, Word Muncher, Math Blaster, and a great variety of other games that trigger some serious nostalgia in my generation. All games that are clearly gamifying the process of learning subjects covered in grade school and, less commonly, middle and high school. Unfortunately, there's something of a divide between these kinds of games and for-fun games, to the point where very few educational games bear much resemblance to more typical games, and only so many of them are actually much fun at all. They would sometimes try to emulate educational shows, like, say, The Magic School Bus, but the addition of gameplay makes it a little more difficult, since it's hard to teach through gameplay without basically turning the gameplay into fancy-looking homework. Few games bridge this gap with much success, and they tend to be for younger children, but the vast majority of educational games have tried this approach. Civilization is not that kind of game, but it's also far from the only game to have a lot of educational potential by simulating a subject. Except that instead of cities, anthills, or towers, it simulates civilization, like the whole of our technological and cultural development as a species. Obviously, the educational potential is pretty high. But the series isn't very directly educational, we'll say. You can play as one of many civilizations from all across history, and each of them are designed to visually look historically accurate. And in one of the neater touches of the series, each of these civilizations also has a few unique mechanics that are reflective of their cultural and societal tendencies. And reflecting that sort of thing through the mechanics of the gameplay is always just really awesome. However, this also means that the actual progression of a game of Civilization is not historically accurate, to say the absolute least. I could start a game in the ancient era as the United States, literal millennia before the nation would even exist, and as the United States, I could build the pyramids, proclaim Jedi to be my national religion, and then eventually go to nuclear war with the Mayans. Or Gandhi. Gandhi loves nuclear weapons in this game. Taken at face value, I think it's obvious that we can't really call that educational. It makes National Treasure look like a documentary in comparison. But there is a little more to it than that, and to understand how, we're going to need to talk a bit about a concept called tangential learning. Tangential learning is a process wherein learning is facilitated and inspired rather than being directly communicated. So if something has ever inspired you to go look deeper into something and learn more about it, that's tangential learning at work. So, for instance, if a kid really loves Halo and loves the Spartans, they might decide to look into the historical Spartans for which the series' super soldiers are named. Or, when I was younger, I first heard of some mythological figures like Shiva and Ramu by playing Final Fantasy VII. It's a general principle of human behavior that we learn better when we're engaged in what's going on, which means that inserting something we need to know into something we already care about has the potential to get us interested and inspire us to learn more on our own time. It's a far more effective way of learning than at the command of a teacher and through a dry, boring textbook that none of us wants to actually read. Most things we can learn about are interesting to one degree or another. In keeping with the theme of civilization, history has a whole lot of interesting stuff to learn about, but I know when I was in school, I didn't give a crap about it. But when Assassin's Creed II put me into Venice, or even when Jeanne d'Arc turned history into high fantasy, I genuinely wanted to learn more about what I was seeing. Civilization isn't educational on the direct level that you'd expect from something like a documentary or a textbook, but it is something of a goldmine for tangential learning about history. The most obvious element of this is the simple fact that so many historical elements of the game exist in the first place. A single game of Civilization will expose the player to a huge amount of historical buildings, cultures, and concepts. But beyond that, civilization's entire simulation is that of humankind's development. Sure, you may be playing as the Aztecs surviving into the modern age, but the progression from a simple, uncultured community to a sprawling, advanced civilization and the difficulties that face you along the way all give a general picture of how our species got to where it is today. And again, the mechanical representation of units and civilizations is excellent. You may not know what Borobudur is, but since it gives you 3 missionaries once it's built, you'll have a basic understanding of what it is anyway. But the most important tool for tangential learning in this series is the Civilopedia. These games actually have a freaking encyclopedia inside them with all the historical things they reference, so you don't even need to leave the game to find out more about anything that interests you. So if we're asking whether civilization is educational, the answer is questionable. It's certainly not the same kind of educational that we expect from more traditional educational media. But if we're asking whether it has the potential for education or to facilitate learning, absolutely it does. You certainly wouldn't want to sit a classroom down in front of this game and say, "Play this, this is how history happened." But I could see a number of educational uses for this game. I think my personal favorite would be having the students play a game of Civilization and then use the Civilopedia to write up something about some of the concepts and historical figures that they came across. But I'm sure that any teacher who really puts their mind to it could come up with a great number of uses for it. And of course, the larger takeaway from this is that video games absolutely can help us learn while entertaining us. And in fact, oftentimes, this medium is at its best while it's teaching us something through the worlds and the stories and the gameplay that we enjoy so much. So, here's to a series that's trying to do just that. If you have any other insights into the educational nature of the Civilization series, feel free to talk about them in the comments. And if you enjoyed the episode, please consider subscribing, and don't forget to check the description for links to Games as Lit 101 on Facebook, Twitter, and Patreon if you like the show enough to support it in exchange for some cool rewards. Next week, we're getting into a kind of large and touchy subject at the request of one of my generous patrons, the handling of sex in video games. And a couple weeks from now, don't forget, we're going to be giving the literary analysis treatment to the classic PlayStation RPG, The Legend of Dragoon. So, until next week, class dismissed. Tunacho itaji utusumehe makosa yetu.